exactly 3 minutes past 10 a.m. and we're getting into the love letter this morning on the show. And in case you're just joining us, you can be sure to catch what we've been talking about for the past 1 hour by heading over to our social media pages, which are always very active. Facebook, Urban Television, and Twitter, it is at Urban TV Uganda. Remember, in case you want to get in touch with us, you can use the hashtag Urban Today, and we'll definitely have that message directed to us. Now, the biggest question here that we are addressing is, should I choose my best friend as a best man? Now, hello, Urban Today. I have been dating my very cool woman for 4 years, and now 2 months ago, I proposed at the island, and she said, yes, plans for our wedding are in high gear, and everyone is excited for us. My dilemma, though, is choosing a best man. I have been friends with my best friend since high school, and I believe he knows me in and out. So automatically, I thought he would be the best man. Unfortunately, he is not married, and some people around me think I need a married man to be my best man because he knows all about marriage. And one of the roles of the best man is to help the marriage stronger. What should I do? Please advise me.
I mean, first of all, I'm going to say y'all can go kick rocks, walk off short cliffs, hang by a vine. With all this nonsense and superstition, this is one thing I'm going to tell you. Marriage is like preventing. Marriage has no guidelines. Marriage has no rules. It has no rule book. As in, the way your marriage is with a particular person is not the way another person's marriage is. Just like friendships. I don't think it all has to be best on if he is married or not. As a person, do you feel he has your best interests at heart? Akumanyi in and out. Akutegera. Can you call on him at any time and tell him, yo, me and the missus is fighting? If he checks all those boxes, just do it.
Okay.
Because at the end of the day, I have seen couples get best men and, you know, maids of honor. But then you see them going through the shaky bits of their marriages. And they're getting the advice from a totally different group of people. You get what I'm saying? So for me, it is a very huge honor who you decide to be your maid of honor or your best man. It's a huge honor. And I believe it can't be any better than your friend who understands you. Not just some guy who has been married for, you know, years on end, and you feel he's the one who will give you advice, my dear. Every person's marriage is individual to itself.
Okay.
If your friend is your mfanfe, tanowo, akutegera, webyononeka, jakuja, let the man be your best man.
Let the man be the best man. As long as Teta Malanga yafuse kawasa, until you travel away from the world, you have to go and back
home.
Yeah, the best man.
You don't always have to adulterate.
No, but you have to look at all options. Everything is possible.
I mean, he didn't even mention if his best friend knows his wife to be.
I'm just saying, I'm looking at, you know.
But you know, there's some duties that. Wait, where are we?
Willis, you are almost getting married. And what best
advice?
We can't
wait. Thank you. You're not going to be his best man.
Amen. Thank you very much. I take the
blessing. No, I wouldn't want to be the best man.
I take the blessing.
I want to be in charge of the drinks. That is the role. Simple as that. The rest, you can sort yourselves. I don't want these things of calling me in the middle of the function. Best man, where are you? Swanya, the Mgole is sweating. No, I want to be.
I think
I want to be the guy they look for on the microphone. And I want to be the guy telling people, ah, you guys, if you can have your why you. And then when Tina comes, I'm like, shh, don't tell anyone. You have.
That is the most important person at any
point. I think that for me, in that, as much as it seems like it's a joke, summarizes what I think.
Okay.
That your best friend should be the person running your wedding, not your best man. Because your best man is a. Their roles come later, and but on that event, they're as busy as you are. So you need someone who has your interests at heart to run your event. They understand your brain. They know what you like and what you don't like. They know who you want to sit where. So for me, that summarizes part of what I want to say. But here's what I want to say: that there's a story we all know around the city of a guy who has had a woman who is his best friend, I think, as a best man.
Yeah.
Yes.
For, I think, twice. but all his marriages have failed.
Mm. Ooh.
Yes. He has divorced the first wife, got the second one. I think
she
got the same.
She the problem.
Mm.
So
he banging
so
that.
What should I say? That mm-hmm. is the best friend the problem? I don't know. I'm not there. Mm. But I think, like a you know, a viewer, that she could be the problem.
Okay.
Mm. One, why?
She what has bad luck?
Not bad luck.
Mm. Gives wrong
but
advice.
One is that you need to put into consideration that birds of a feather flock together, and it works with men.
Mm-hmm.
That when I'm best friends with Derek, when we're at a band, check out a chick, chances are that
you
if
all
I like
see the
her,
same chick.
He likes her too.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are birds of a feather. We like the same things. That's what makes friendship.
Mm-hmm.
We do the same things, we like the same things.
But
so
mean
chances
that when you
are,
bang, that I'll also bang.
Yes, but I like.
But
so
the
if circumstances
are,
present
geez,
themselves.
Why are we using my example again?
I don't know.
Let us
when circumstances present themselves, chances are that your best friend might bang what you've banged.
That's true.
But
that's
the chances
true.
Of your best friend still banging what you banged, even if you're not married or him not being your best man, are extremely high.
So here is the thing.
You also have to put
so
into consideration that we have
friend,
the bro code.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but as you have a best friend as your best man, chances are that you're coming to this best man who is your best friend for advice when things are not working out.
Yes.
Chances are that if he had liked and wanted to bang, he's going to.
Then that means you don't trust your friend. That
no, it's not trust.
They
it's not about trust.
Let me simplify this for you.
As friends, you may like the same person. Or you know, I may see someone. I have the same taste and I like him like you. That chick, man, she's good. And you're like, oh, that chick is fine. And you know, if I go ahead and have a thing with this chick, you know, and I'm like, you by the Willis, man, I think I'm making it official here.
Mm.
Then you'd be like, yeah, okay, Kawa, if you're making it official there, man, that's a no-go zone.
Mm.
You get
the
but
bro
then,
code.
The bro code, yes.
Yes.
But right. Then there are those people, I'm going to be like, Willis, man, Tina, fire.
So
and
what
I finish, and then I come to you, and I'm like,
so what
dandy. Then you're like, but let me also go there, and I'm like, it's okay.
What if you have
go? That's also a bro code.
You see, we have a bro code,
yes.
But what if the other party does not respect that bro code?
One
you understand.
Then you're
Willis,
not you're,
so,
Willis,
then you're not supposed to be even called my brother in the first place.
Yes, Willis, right here, you're playing in a very nuclear space.
I
what
know.
I'm going to say is one, your problem is one, thou shalt not trust another man around your woman. That's what your problem is. Because even if they are your friend, you feel at some point there could be a car, eh? A car slip and
I mean,
slide.
We
which
we,
means something if your brother, your brother, was getting a little bit too, you'll be like, hey, blood, I am single.
We all have that one friend in a circle. Who you know?
Yes. No,
you
no,
cannot leave your woman with
here's
them.
Here's where I'm going with this boat.
Jesus.
Here's where I'm going with the boat. That remove best friend or stranger from the best man office and leave best man office empty.
Alone.
That it is. It can happen that your wife attended Walidwa and wants the best man. It is better that she goes with a stranger than a brother. Because with a brother, I might kill you and end up in jail. But with a stranger, I will just die with my pain.
Really?
So that is one of the reasons why
I would prefer to
just choose.
Yeah, because even during breakups, let me tell you, during heartbreaks, we tend to be very honest with people we don't know at the bar counter. And you know, you're with someone, he says hi, and you're like, man, hi. And he's like, are you okay? And you're like, no. You start telling them your whole love story. And with a friend, you're like, you don't tell them too much because they know you
trust.
Too much.
That's why I don't even got friends because of that issue.
Yeah.
So it is better.
So it is better
your chick
for
gets
me,
banged
in my
by
view.
A stranger
than, yeah.
than the brother.
So
the
when you're choosing a best man, in this case, I would say that choose someone who is respected in the institution of marriage. Someone who will sit you down and say, look, this is the truth about marriage.
Mm-hmm.
When she says, I don't want at midnight, stay awake up to 3. You understand?
Yeah.
That is advice too.
But your best friend has your interests at heart. When you tell a man, Yaganye, he will say, when she refuses at midnight, catch her at 30:30. Because they have your interest. They want you to gain.
They're standing by you, not the
institution of marriage.
First, listen, let me. This is what I'm going to explain to you. By the time like you've said, birds of a feather flock
together. Yes.
By the time, Willis, I'm your friend, I come to you and I'm like, hey, yo, man, I'm going to make it official with my woman. And me and you have been through it all, right? We've been through the ups, the downs, the lows, and the highs. So what better person than the person who knows my ups and my downs?
Being the best
than
man.
Than you being my best man, because we have taken so many journeys together. Please, let's embark on this one too and get through it.
How about you be in charge of the drinks at the party? Make sure I'm not...
No, that doesn't make me significant.
Make sure that my ex... Make sure that my ex is not parking next to our...
No, you don't get it.
You
don't get it.
Guys,
that is you being a statistic.
We know all my exes. If my best friend is in charge of the drinks, my friend, I have a earcom. If my ex shows up, he's like, yo, it's about to get fire. Hurry up.
You guys are forgetting one thing.
Oh, yeah.
According to, you know, the Christianity marriage, when you're in church, your best man
has to be married. Married.
Yes.
This is someone who's going to sign on your marriage certificate and, you know, whatever it's
needed. You can actually alter it because you don't have to go to church.
What if it's a church marriage?
Have the church come to you.
What if it's a church marriage? What if you guys are Christians and, you know, basing on your relationship, you guys have been going
to church
and you have agreed that, you know what, we're going
to
get married in church.
Oh,
fine, the church is coming to us. But at the end of the day, even if the church is coming to you, if it's a marriage, it's a wedding, the best man has to be
married.
It's mandatory.
Do you know that before you even sign your church certificate in church, you have to have signed it with the courts of law first? So basically, your first marriage is in the courts of law.
But it's mandatory for you.
It's mandatory, your first real union, where you'll share names together.
I think it's very selfish for you to choose your best friend as your best man, because you're not looking at the marriage itself, but you're looking at your
interests. Oh, come on, now you're
individual.
Going too deep.
So now you're saying, I want someone who has my goalpost at heart.
Because but she's also going to get high.
Yeah, but you forget that you need someone who has the institution of marriage at heart. You need someone who's going to sit down with the maid of honor and say, you know what, you're that side, I'm this side, but this is what marriage is about. You understand? Not someone who just thinks, Derek brought this in the marriage. He needs to have these rights respected.
I think that's why most couples are opting lately. When we're picking a best man and a maid of honor, we actually pick a couple.
Oh, like this guy's a married. The maid of honor
already,
the best man, the marriage.
But then a problem I have with that is that I have attended way too many weddings. That's why I stopped attending weddings, where everything seems that proper in a line, in the line that you're saying, and life goes on 1 year, 2 years, and then in the third year, the marriage is crumbling, and then the best man and the maid of honor are trying to help, and then they're like, yo, first of all, for us, we gave you all we have used in our marriage. We don't know
how to keep you. But also,
we can't. But your friend on the other hand will tell you, yo, blood.
This is how it's supposed to be.
But
does
you know,
that
the
advice have to
eat.
Come when, you know, you have made this friend of yours the best man? Can't he still advise
he
you like
still
that
does.
When
he
he's
still
not
does.
The best
no,
man?
Because his dilemma right now is if he should choose his unmarried best friend to be his best man. And reading in the subliminal, he actually believes if he did, he wouldn't be disappointed.
Well, he could be, emotionally clouded his judgment. But you see, also the other angle is that, to be fair, because as men, we don't have just one best friend. So to
men
be
don't
fair,
have
to
best friends.
Men have many best friends.
No way.
Like Derek,
ours is never that
how
deep.
How can you be?
No.
Wait, how can you have very many best friends?
A man's best friend, like that one best friend is a woman. But men's best friend, I have a best friend for the bar. I have Tony when I'm in a bar and it's a bar, it's a fight.
Wait, take it back.
A man's best friend, like that one, when you say, who is your best friend?
It's usually a chick.
That's the person you open up and they know.
So y'all have been friend zoning your sister?
You have friends who you think are their best friends?
No, listen, you don't get it. Like, I thought we're just friends, and at some point we could, you know, who knows?
But these guys
have literally made me a sister.
Do not overcross the line. You are in the best friend zone, not the sister zone.
No.
Actually,
you
see, when you're in the best friend zone, best friend zone, you have like a chance of, you know.
No.
But once I put you in the sister zone, you're literally close to the ancestral zone.
These guys have put me in the ancestral
zone. No, don't worry, because in a man's best friend zone, Msaja inzo tende walirwa.
I don't want to be a bully.
I was going on with the best friend, that a man's best friend is a woman, but men have best friends. Our best friends are, I have Tony. When a fight is breaking out in the bar, Tony is on my side, I am sure.
Even if you're wrong,
yes, that's true. I have a best friend for when we are supporting teams. Yo, Manu Ajikubi, Ajakaba Nang, even if he doesn't support Manu, he doesn't know football. So men have best friends. You know, my kids, there's my best friend who takes care of my home. Like, my kids are going to school and what, he's there when I'm in sick in hospital, he's there. So
then
men are like that.
Does that make me a man too?
No. For you, a best friend of when
I'm
down,
I think this should be another love letter we get into. Because I feel like there's a lot that is going on this side.
No, you don't get it. The question
I guess
asked,
that is
no,
why...
No, the way you explained a guy... No.
Nagama, now why don't I make my real best friend my best
my
man?
Best man.
No, don't you take it, Dechendo, Ziza. You have explained how men become best friends. They have best friends for every area code, right? And it just hit me. I think I'm a man. I have a best friend for every area code.
Yeah,
but is that your best friend is now a man.
And then there's also like a best friend who can, you know, turn things around.
You see,
a
best
friend.
I made that mistake once. I ended up having
a best
two
friend
babies. I'm not doing it again.
You understand?
Now, I had two kids with. I'm not making that mistake.
With a best friend.
A proper man is not going to come to a fellow man and say, "Mwana, kokachi, kikati, kikati." But he's going to go to that cup best friend who's a chick and be like,
"There's a fire!
That's what we are." But anyway, they have it. At the end of the day, Willis is saying it's not okay for you to actually have your best friend as your best man. Tina is saying, no, it's all good to have your best friend as your best man. And now, at the end of the day, it is up to you. What are you going to be doing? We shall be getting into some feedback, of course, later on that is on Facebook. And we'll find out what is the best option for you to take as you get close to your wedding day. We're going for a very short break. Why don't we do get back? Nicholas will be joining us for the latest of what is happening in the sports scenes.